The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 11, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 11th of February, 1975, in Mexico.
Sri Bhagavan Uvacha, Asatya Nanna Suchastang, Pragyabhadang Subhasase, Gatasuna, Gatasunangcha, Nanna Suchanti, Pandita. He, Bhagavan Uvacha. Bhagavan means the Supreme Being. In the English dictionary, when you consult the word God, it is stated there, the Supreme Being. What is that Supreme Being? We are all living beings, but amongst ourselves there is comparative superlative positions. I am here, you are here, he is there. So you may be better than me, he may be better than you, and somebody else may be better than him. In this way, you go on searching after one better than the other, when you ultimately come to a point that nobody is better than him, that is Bhagava. Bhaga means opulence. So there are six kinds of opulences. One opulence is to become very rich. Another opulence is to become very powerful. Another opulence is to become very strong. Another opulence is to become very famous. Another opulence is to become very wise. And another opulence is to become very much renowned. So these six kinds of opulences, when present in the superlative degree, that is Bhagavan. This means, as it is stated in the basic literature, natasya sama adhikasta drishyate. Nobody is found equal to him or greater than him. In this material world, any person you take, next moment you will find somebody equal to him and somebody greater than him. But the Vedic information is, God means who has no equal and who has no greater person than him. Actually, Bhagavad Gita was spoken by Krishna, and here it is said, Bhagavan Uvacha. The Bhagavan, the Supreme God, means Krishna. That is the statement in all Vedic literature. Ishara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha Anadi Radi Govinda Sarvakarana Karana. Means that Ishara, controller, the Supreme Controller is Krishna. We are also controller. I control a few people, you control a few men, another control more men, another more men, or you can go on. But the Supreme Controller, who controls everyone, all big controllers, that is Krishna. Therefore, when it is said Bhagavan Uvacha, that means the version which is presented herewith was spoken by the Supreme Controller. So our process of receiving knowledge is from the Supreme Controller. Because according to the definition already given, wise, the most wise, Krishna or Bhagavan is the most wise. Therefore, if we receive knowledge from the most wise, then there is no flaw. That is our principle, that we are receiving from Krishna, the Supreme Controller, directly. Just like when there is some misunderstanding, we take help from the law books. Because in the law book or in the law court, the decision is obligatory to both the parties. So to give knowledge, there are many, many parties, but when we receive knowledge from the Supreme, that is all-inclusive. Here Krishna says, asachyan anna suchastang pragyabhadang suhasa. Arjuna has accepted the guidance of Krishna. He has said previously that the position is very perplexing, therefore I accept you as my spiritual master and you kindly give me enlightenment. This is the process. We should approach the Supreme or the representative of the Supreme. Just like the same example, when there is any controversy, we refer to the law book or to the lawyer, or we take the decision of the law court and that is final. So here Krishna says to Arjuna that because he has accepted the leadership of Krishna, therefore Krishna is chastising him in this way. He is chastising in this way that Arjuna was talking with Krishna as friends. So friends means equal status, but he gave up that status. He took the status of a disciple. A disciple means who voluntarily agrees to be disciplined by the spiritual master. When one becomes disciple, he cannot disobey the order of the spiritual master. Shishya, shishya, this word comes from the root sasdhatu, means I accept your ruling. So previously Arjuna has accepted shishyastiham sadhimam prapannam. I am now surrendered to you and I agree voluntarily to accept your ruling. This is the relationship between the spiritual master and the disciple. So we have got 10 kinds of offenses in chanting the Hare Krishna mantra. The first offense is Guru Ravagya, means to disobey the orders of Guru, spiritual master. One cannot disobey the orders of Guru. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, although he is Krishna himself, he also says, Guru more murkha dekhi korila sasan. My Guru, my spiritual master, saw me a fool, and therefore he has chastised me. So therefore, because Arjuna has accepted Krishna as Guru, therefore he is chastising him that you are lamenting on a subject matter which is not done by any learned man. That means you are not a learned man, you are fool. The learned man does not do like this. That means you are not learned man because you are doing this. So Krishna said that you practically, you are not in the knowledge of things, still you are lamenting on the bodily concept of life. Anyone who accepts his body as self, he is not only learned, but he is compared with the animal. That is the statement in the Vedic literature. Jashato buddhi kunapeti dhatuke sadhik kalatra dhishubhavma ijyadhi jatirtha buddhi salile nakarhiti janesu avidgesu saeva gokharo. Go means cow and kharo means ass. So anyone who accepts this body as self, he is animal, he is not human being. That is the beginning of knowledge. People are accepting knowledge from school, college, university, but at the present moment at least, how many people know that he is not body? Unless we understand this first principle of knowledge, there is no question of spiritual advancement of life. So, the beginning of Bhagavad Gita is to give lesson that we are not this body. It will be later on explained that the spirit soul or the real person is within this body. Just like we are here, we are within this heart and core, but we are not this heart and core. So, if the certain coat is torn, if somebody becomes mad after it and lamenting, that is not very good sense. Therefore he is saying that asat charanu sutastam. You are lamenting on the subject matter which is never done by any learned man. A ship without rudder or without captain. A ship without captain, he has not mentioned, but Bhagavat has mentioned. Now you don't bring any other question. You talk about this which you have lectured. In this way, if you bring other question, that is not. We are discussing one verse. You can put question on this, not irrelevant question. Of course, that is not irrelevant, but not in connection with this verse. So question means in connection with this verse. How do you understand when you go for treatment to a physician? How do you understand that here is a physician? How do you understand? Tell me. Huh? Yes. Somehow or other, you know that he is a physician. And similarly, you have to find out Guru. Guru, first of all, who requires a Guru? That is the question. Because Guru is not a fashion. It is said in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Tasmat Gurum Prabhadet. On account of this, you should go to a Guru. What is that account? Tasmat Gurum Prabhadeta Jignashu Sreya Uttamam. One who is very much inquisitive to know about spiritual affair, he requires a Guru. Spiritual affair means that we are in this material world, we are suffering. When the question will come in one's mind, why I am suffering? That is spiritual. Just like an animal is being taken to the slaughterhouse, he cannot inquire why I am being taken to the slaughterhouse. But if a man is being taken forcibly, he will protest, he will cry, he will call crowd. Therefore, human being can inquire about spiritual affair. So, when there is spiritual inquiry, then one requires a Guru. And by going to Guru, as it is stated, tadviddhi pranipatena pariprasneno sevaya. One has to learn by surrendering, pranipat. So, first of all, there must be a strong impulse to inquire about the transcendental subject matter. Then one requires a Guru. Not that to follow a fashion that one has Guru. Acharyavan Purusha Veda. Unless one becomes under the control of Acharya, he has no perfect knowledge. Therefore the Veda says, Tadvijnanartham sa gurumeva abhigacchet. For understanding the transcendental science, one must approach a Guru. And what is the symptom of Guru? Samitpani Srutiyam Brahmanishtam. Guru means one who has complete knowledge of Vedic version, and not only that, he is a staunch or fixed-up devotee of the Supreme Lord. These are the qualities. The Guru strictly follows the Vedic injunction and teaches the same thing to his disciple. That is Guru. So, first thing is, one must be inquisitive to understand about the spiritual subject matter. Just like you have come here in this temple, you know that here nothing like political meeting is going on. Here something spiritual matter is being discussed. Therefore you have come. This inclination is the beginning of spiritual life. This is called Shraddha. Shraddha means faith. So this Shraddha has to be developed further. And to develop this Shraddha or faith, one has to associate with persons who are keeping with this faith. Therefore it is said, Adau Shraddha Tato Sadhu Sangha. First of all faith, then to associate with persons who are devotees and faithful. In this way, when further development is done, then Ato Bhajana Kriya means the learning, the process of devotional service. No gambling, no meat eating. These are not wanted. In the beginning of life, nobody smokes or nobody becomes intoxicated. It is learned by bad association. Similarly, it can be given up by good association. They are called anarthas. Anartha means unwanted bad habits. So, when we are children, innocent, we have no bad habits. But as we grow and associate with bad company, we also acquire all these bad habits. So to give up all these bad habits means we have to associate with sadhus or devotees, saintly person, then we can give it up. This is called anartha nivritti, means giving up all unwanted bad habits. These things are not wanted. Nobody dies if he does not smoke or drink. Nobody dies. Artificially we learn it, so by good association we can give it up. So when we are purified out of all the bad habits, then we become fixed up in spiritual knowledge. In this way we make advance in spiritual life, and at the last stage we become lover of God. This is the process, and one who teaches this process, he is guru. This is the definition of guru. I do not know what you say. Where it is? No, when we are teaching, it is because the people are suffering on account of ignorance. Therefore we are teaching. How? We are callous. We are not callous, we are very much sympathetic to give them knowledge. How do you say? The devotees are not callous. Why they are touring all over the world, accepting so much trouble, opposition? Because they are very much sympathetic with the people who are suffering out of ignorance. They are the most sympathetic friend of the human society. So this is not true that they are callous. Any other question? If you don't commit offense, why do you voluntarily commit offense? You should not commit offense. Then it will be all right, purified. By performing sankirtan. Just like if a man drinks, and if he drinks, then he becomes a drunkard. Drink more and he becomes a drunkard. Similarly, chant more and he becomes a perfect chanter. Yes, that is the first offense. Guru Rabagya, Suti Shastra Nindanam, Suti Shastra Nindanam, Guru Rabagya. If you accept Guru and again disobey him, then what is your position? You are not a gentleman. He promised before Guru, before Krishna, before fire, that I shall obey your order, I shall execute this. And again, you do not do this, then you are not even a gentleman. What to speak about devotee? This is common sense. You cannot understand? He can take prasadam. Bhaktivinoda Thakur has said like that, Tar madhye jivbhavati lobho moy sudur mati, tare jeta kothina sansare. Out of all the senses, the tongue sense is very powerful. So it is very difficult to control it. So he says, Tar madhye jivbhavati lobho moy sudur mati. The tongue is very greedy and very difficult to be controlled. Therefore, Krishna has given us one weapon. What is that? Krishna varo dayamaya kuribari jivha joy saprasad annadila bhai. Krishna is very kind. Therefore, he has given us his remnants of foodstuff. So if we make this promise that I shall not take anything which is not offered to Krishna, then your tongue will be controlled. And in the Shastra it is said, that you cannot understand Krishna. Atah Sri Krishna Namadi, not only Krishna, even his name, you cannot understand with these imperfect senses. Atah Sri Krishna Namadi Nabhavet Grayam Indriyai Sevan Mukhe Hi Jivhado Swami Vaspurattada. But when you engage your tongue in the service of Krishna, then Krishna reveals himself. Sir, the tongue's business is twofold. One is, with tongue we speak, we vibrate sound. And another business is, with tongue we taste nice foodstuff. So if you engage this tongue in the matter of Krishna's service by vibrating Hare Krishna mantra. And if you don't allow your tongue to touch anything which is not offered to Krishna, then you become immediately Krishna realized. So when the tongue is controlled, all other senses are automatically controlled. This is the problem.